This is real life, little home, that's why I stayed down. I done came up off that boy, look what I made now. Like Nike, I just do this, ain't a game now. I try to get a job, but they turn me down. I know life ain't fair, that's why I don't play around. I know these bitches scap as hell, that's why I don't go around. I know these bitches very well, they ain't gon' hold you down. So I'm out here on my lonely, getting money now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, ain't no stopping now. I got guap now, since I've been out. I'm on the top now, rockstar now. I can't turn down, I can't turn down.
I chose the life I'm living, out here trapping, getting it. Turn to work the bitches, all I think's terrific. I tried to get a job, but I didn't get it. So I'm out here getting it. I chose the life I'm living, gold balls, bad minds. I chose the life I'm living. With the props, I chose the life I'm living. Born fast, hard, I chose the life I'm living. I chose the life I'm living. I chose the life I'm living.
I have no patience, cause the time that I miss. Ain't no time for no games. Around, I gotta get it. My mama need me, my nephews, my little sisters. So I'm juggling like I'm scooter. Man, I'm getting to that moolah. If you're in the way, you better move. Cause I'm killing it, it's so cool. And I'm playing pussy like food. I don't sleep, no snooze. Cause I'm trying to win, not lose. Vacations on cruise. They take patience, I know. Down south, me and my bros. They go wherever I go. They strap to every show. My fam, I do this whole. My life was on hold. Now my life back on gold. Cause this the life I
chose, cause this is the life I chose, cause this is the life I chose. I chose the life I'm living, out here trapping, getting it. Turn to work to Benji's, all of this terrific. I tried to get a job, but I didn't get it. So I'm out here getting it. I chose the life I'm living, gold balls, bad balls. I chose the life I'm living, cold minds with the rocks. I chose the life I'm living, more fast cars. I chose the life I'm living, I chose the life I'm living. I chose the life I'm living.
Test one, test two.
Gather around. I have a story to tell. It's about people who have jobs, the self-employed, hustlers, and business owners. Of late, we've been having this conversation, and there are people who want to feel good about what they're doing. I understand that. If you do not have this situation where you could go on a trip to Italy, leave your business, and when you come back, it's still running. It's still making money while you have taken your finger off of it. If you don't have that kind of situation, you do not have a business. Just put that out there, because there are many people, I'm about my business, I'm doing this. You have a situation of either being self-employed or hustling. You essentially have created a job for yourself, which is That's great. That's an amazing thing. However, let me tell you the story. High-grade hustling. The upscale garage sale. We had employees. We had trucks. We had leases. We had a warehouse. We had online distribution points. But it was just a very high-grade hustle. Why? When my partner was diagnosed with cancer, when I got sick, the business stopped. If you have a situation where your business can't run without you, you're not a business owner. And I'm making this distinction because these comments that keep coming in, because I understand people want to feel good about themselves. Yeah, I started this business. Yeah, I'm hustling. I've, you know, upgraded my income in a few weeks. Let's go ahead and talk about the numbers too. Let's talk about the numbers. You can make 100K a year hustling. You can make 100K a year flipping stuff on Craigslist. You can make $100K a year doing stuff on eBay. You can make $100K a year doing stuff on Amazon. You can make $100K a year with a successful YouTube channel. You can make $100K a year with a successful Instagram account. But if you stop doing what you're doing, they all fall down. These are jobs disguised as businesses. Kind of looks like a business, kind of feels like a business, kind of tastes like a business. But when you look at it, it's not organized or set up like a business. This is where things become problematic. This is where things fall off the rails. This is where people run into problems because everybody wants to feel good about themselves. I had someone who had put this question, this comment under my video. Now, I thought I did a good job of explaining that. I want you guys to get, I want you guys to get into the 9.9%, which has an overall net worth of $1.5 million up to $5 million. This is the launch pad for future millionaires and billionaires. You set your kids up and you may even set yourself up, but you got to get in there first because you remove yourself from normal bills and car payments and car debt and student loan debt. You clean, you can make moves, you can sit down and ponder, you can come up with ideals. You can take time and run experiments. You are not relaxed because the people in the 9.9% are working, but you have more options, you have more money. Be clear on that before someone puts in this comment. Just because you replaced your $11.50 per hour job with a hustle that now earns you $3,000 per month,
you've moved the cheese. Once again, yay! Congratulations, wonderful. You get a car, you get a car.
You've done something. But that ain't what I'm talking about. To be clear, to be distinct, for clarity. So you replace a job with a higher paying job. Congratulations. But that ain't what I'm talking about. Just to be clear, this is what happened to me. And I'm going to explain this. When I started GC Solutions, I was replacing my income with a similar income, except I was just now self-employed. That income allowed me to roll off into the storage auction business with some capital, with some money, because it was a job, it wasn't a business, I was self-employed, but I had a high income.
I'm gonna stick it. And I do this in love, because many of you don't get it, because once again, replacing that $11.50 per hour job, replacing that $15 per hour job with a hustle that makes you $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 a month, you've done something, but that's commencement. That's the beginning. That ain't no final destination.
And that's what many of you feel, because now that you've replaced that $12.13 per hour job with an eBay hustle, with an Amazon hustle, with whatever you're doing, you now feel that you're business owners. You ain't a business owner, you're a hustler. You're a self-employed hustler, which is a good thing because that puts you in the position to move to the next level. The next level, you're making 20, 30, 40, 50, 100K a month. 20K a month is $240,000 a year. Just a little bit short of putting you in the 1% of income earners in the world. You make 25K per month, you're in the 1%. You, even after taxes, have enough money to live where you want, drive what you want, invest how you want, and save how you want. This is where things begin to happen. This is where the place, the things that begin to change. Because if you replace that $15 per hour job with, let's see, what is 15 bucks an hour? All right, that's 30K a year. So you replace income of $2,500 per month, and let's say you double your income to $5,000. Here's a few problems, and I see it all over the business space, the hustler space, the self-employment space. your income ain't consistent. So you might make $5,000, but you only make it for 6 months out of the year. So you're really no better than that $15 per hour job. You're in the same economic space. And if you're in the same economic space, you can't escape. I say this in love. I say this to address mindsets. I say this to shape people up, because what's going to happen is you're thinking that you're knocking the bottom out of it and she's bored and she's just moaning to make your ego feel good. That's kind of what's happening with this self-employment thing. If your business cannot run itself without you, you don't have a business. You're self-employed. Now, if you're a highly paid self-employed person, you could take the money and employ employees, and you can put in processes and you can create stuff. I did that last year for my consulting business, and I'm going to do that again for my media company. But currently I am self-employed. I have a few things that act like a business. I have Amazon affiliate, not Amazon affiliate, but Amazon Kindle income coming in. I have YouTube income coming in. And even if I don't post any videos, that income will come in for maybe 6 or 7 months, or maybe a year or two, just depending on how the algorithm is acting. So that's a lot of passive income. Last year, when I was consulting, I made $110,000 passive income. But the passive income was because I was actively doing stuff. If you're not at that $20,000 to $25,000 level with your hustle, you're going to run into some problems. Let's talk about me. I was consulting last year, making a lot of money. I don't have any debt. I don't have any bills. I'm not saying this to brag. I'm not saying this to boast. I'm saying that this is an economic reality for me to make the moves that I want to make. I have to run lean, because I think one of the hardest things to happen, and this is why I don't date poor chicks, is if you say those words, "I love you," and you got money and she got needs, and you ain't throwing any money on those needs, then you don't love her. So then you got energy that you could be using to make more money going into fighting with her. She is actually lowering you. She's actually reducing what you can do because she sees that money and she wants a little bit. She ain't about enlightening you. She ain't about elevating you. This is why, like, the chicks I date, they don't have money problems, so I don't have to worry about that. When you, as a emerging business owner, because once you get to 20, 25K, you can start shaping up some stuff to create a sustainable business. Once again, I stepped back from consulting the way that I was, because I will start that again. I'll talk about that toward the end of the video or the stream. I don't know how I'm going to do it. Just depends on how I feel. We need to get more people with the right education, the right verbiage, because right now you have 1,000,001 people online screaming their business owners. They get sick, no business. They don't want to do it anymore, no business. They take a day off, no money. These are not businesses. Now let's talk about a job. Something I say that you should keep while you work on your side hustle, your hustle, your side business, whatever you want to call it. You say that. What is a job? A job is something that you have where you can actually get paid for doing nothing. I know a lot of you out there, I hear it in the stream, it's like, "Hey, I'm supposed to be working, but I'm listening to this stream." And they still gonna get paid their check. That doesn't work with self-employment. That does work with owning a business. Once again, I did not quit my job to jump into self-employment. And also, to be fair, I was already self-employed, so it wasn't a big transition because I was 100% commission salesperson. There is a transition from going to getting a check, whether you work as hard as you can or you don't, you still get paid the same. That was a problem for me. That's why I stepped out here on this entrepreneur ledge. I want to be paid what I'm worth. I need to be paid what I'm worth. But they ain't going to happen with a job. Jobs are necessary. And there are some people, that's all they're going to have in life. They're going to be a very good employee. Now, hustling is kind of good and it's kind of bad. Most hustlers hustle unfocused. You ever see these Instagrams where I'm a preacher, I'm a beautician, I do hair, I'm a Notary Public, I dog walk, you know, there's like 18, 19 things they do. That is unfocused hustling. And it ain't good, because that means you will take money any way you can get it. Once again, that's not good, because then you can't build a brand. And if you don't build a brand, it's going to be very hard to differentiate your business from everything else out there. In the stream the other day, someone put in there, man, that tip about wearing a t-shirt with my company name on it got me more business. These are the little things that separate a side hustle, a side business, from a real business. Let's say you start, you know, there was someone who was like, hey, should I sell my car to get a truck? No. Get a lawnmower, put that lawnmower in the trunk, go cut some grass. Take the money that you're building to invest in these new things. I will tell you a story about that. When I got out of the military, I had this notion to cut grass. And I did exactly what this person wanted to do. I traded my car in on a truck. Got to the point, had great credit. But the deal just, the salespeople was like, man, you busting. I had a job. Actually, in the end, I had to take that truck back. And I was glad, because you know what I was doing? Because I was unfocused. I didn't know what I was doing. I drove through Buckhead and I put, you know, wrote down Cameron's Lawn Service on sheets of paper out of a notebook and stuffed them in mailboxes. Didn't know that was illegal. No one ever stopped me. But I was in a brand new truck with a lawnmower hanging out the back of it. I did this about for a week. No one ever called me back. After I take the truck back, this is when I started getting calls. Like a week or two after I took the truck back, call after call after call. So the lesson of that story is you must always be marketing. And remember, there's going to be a lag time from your first marketing efforts, because if I had knew what I know now, I would have been out there every day and I could have started that lawn care business just from sheer hustling. But see, the thing is, many people just hustle and hustle and hustle, and there is no destination to the hustle. And this is where they go wrong. This is why for many long-term hustlers, it is almost the antithesis of who they are to start a structured and organized business. This is the catch 22. As long as they hustling, they making that money. They doing what they want, they're living how they live, they're taking nice vacations. But see, here's a salient truth. One day, you're gonna get old. And this happens with the ladies' men. They get old, they don't pull as much. The dick game ain't as strong. Well, what do you think is going to happen to you when you've hustled for like 30 years and developed a lot of bad habits? Now, all of a sudden, you want to try to start a business with 30 years of bad habits. It's going to be very hard. It's going to be very, very hard. But there's hope. If you start, and this is the formula, and we'll go through the four mandates. Economics, get your body together, get your mental and spirit together. Then fourth is women. Everyone, well, not everyone, many people have got this completely reversed. Women, body, spirit, then business. Now, at this point, don't have any energy for your business, because you spend 75% of your time on other things. So if you invert that process and put most of your money and time and effort into your business, it will pay dividends. Whether it's a business, it's a hustle, it's a side hustle. I just wanted to put this out here because I got people who just don't want to hear the 3 to 5 year deal. It's like, no, I can't hear you. No, I don't want to hear that. Well, whether you want to hear it or not, it's true. And everybody that's become a multimillionaire, everyone that has become a multi-billionaire has gone through this process unless they were born rich. And even to some degree, they've gone through this process because they had money. But if you have money and you spend any money, you don't get more money, you end up broke. So I want you to think about this. What are you doing? Are you hustling? Do you have a side business? Do you have a brand? Are you making, you know, 20-25K a month? That's, to me, is the line where stuff just takes off. That's when you have excess money to invest in other things. You're making 25K a month, you could do your own real estate deals. You don't need no hardcore lender. You just need a little game, a little salesmanship, because you've got the money to actually do a lease purchase, the money to fix up the house, and the money to pay the mortgage and flip it without having to talk to someone else, without having to beg somebody with some money. Someone that put in one of the comments like, you know, you lost a deal when you told them you were going to bring your team out. Come to find out, there's a lien on that property. So I didn't lose the deal because I was bringing out the team. Well, yeah, I did. Actually, I did, because they knew that I was going to find that out because I was doing my due diligence. But thanks for the tip, because once again, I have the money to do my own deals. I don't need to go to the bank. I could do my own deals. Do you understand? When you get to 25, 50, 60K a month, and then you start becoming an investor and you start doing other things outside of your normal business, do you understand how powerful that is? Do you understand that? So once again, from the top, if you replace that $13 and $50 hour job, which is like 30, ain't even 30, it's 28 grand or 30 grand, now you're making like 60 grand through your business, congratulations. But like I said before, that's just the beginning. There ain't no end point. There ain't no destination. And a lot of you are coming at me like, yeah, I'm the man now. I'm the woman. You get sick like I did. Well, that business will go away. And you know these customers? They'll feel for you. They'll be like, oh, man, that is so bad. But I'm going to go over here to merchant X, Y, and Z because I need my stuff. I wish you well. I hope you get better. And, you know, once you start it up again, okay, I'll be back. Maybe. Because they go over to XYZ Merchant, and XYZ Merchant treats them better than I did. They ain't coming back. Momentum is a hard thing to get, and it's a hard thing to maintain. And when you lose it, it's literally like you're starting over from scratch. It really is.